please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
The Nikkei is leading the gains out there with a gain of about 185, 190 points.
And likely that global growth from here, including USA growth, is going to accelerate much from here.
A decisive break, if it happens, which is that we give up the lows of the last two or three days, could pave the way for 200-day moving average test.
It's a 0.25% higher. So 10,500 is where the market opened.
The economy clearly is recovering. The stock market's overvalued, and hopefully between now and the year end, that overvaluation gets sort of cleansed out of the system.
1541. Okay. Now picking up actually, almost 9% now, volumes are also higher.
September quarter was a good quarter for us. I think what happened is the Indian prescription business had a higher mix of the respiratory therapy, which is relatively higher margin for us.
It's been firing on all cylinders for Bharat Forge. These numbers are in line. The street was expecting a good set of numbers, and a good set of numbers is what has come through.
The market is roaring ahead, 138 odd points higher on the Nifty.
That was some time back, and from that point, the market has actually halved the gains, and that's the problem for the market right now. At higher level, they're selling as well, though it has to be said that today has been a good day for the bulls. There's been a bit of a fight back, and there's been across-the-board buying as well. Of course, some numbers flashing from BHEL. They don't look too good, but then that's BHEL for you. Higher, of course, year-on-year, but compared to the pool, the numbers are slightly lower. But Sonia, hi, good afternoon.
Hi, good afternoon. I take your point. You know, when you see any kind of growth from BHEL, you're like, okay, at least there's growth, right?
Yes.
I mean, however paltry it may look, it's just a 2% revenue growth. But I guess it's not too bad given the way BHEL has performed in the past.
Yeah, I mean, you should not have too high expectations as well from BHEL, and that's why, you know, that stock is slipping a bit from the high point. We'll discuss about markets as well, but let's get some thoughts from Anisha on the BHEL numbers. Anisha?
Oh, well, yes, Anuj, actually, as you guys were talking about it, a little growth is also taken well by the street for BHEL. In terms of the numbers, they don't look too exciting, but in terms of the bottom line, it's not too bad. 150 crores, because remember, the expectations were very wide, right from a 70 crore number to a 400 crore number. In terms of operational sense, the other expenses seem to have shot up, because the other expenses came in at 1,100 odd crores versus 700 crore rupees, and that is what is denting the operational performance. The top line is flat, no surprise therein, because Their performance earlier as well has been on similar lines. Other than that, the positive is that employee expenses have not gone up year on year, and that should be taken well by the street. We'll have to wait for the order book number, because this time they have not disclosed it. But the assumption is that it's not going to be a gung-ho number there as well, because we haven't heard much happening with BHEL order inflows in the last couple of months. Back to you.
Okay, Anisha, thanks for that. ACC's numbers are also out, by the way. We'll just flash it for you on the screen. Net profits are 205.7 crores versus a poll of 190 crores. I'm reading from the press release. The cement sales volumes have grown by 27% this time around, and the ready mix business has upheld the double digit volume growth trend with a 19% growth. So the volumes look good. The operating EBITDA has jumped by 54%, and the profit before tax has jumped by 214%. So Nigel's also with us. Nigel, I'm just reading from the release. These cement volumes of 27% and ready mix business at 19%?
Oh, it looks very good. These volume numbers are looking very, very good. And the highest that I had on the street was at around 6.55 million tons. So 6.9 million tons, this is looking very, very good. And I think that's, you know, what's led to the beat on all parameters. There's a top line beat. Even the operating profit, in fact, has come in much higher. We work with a number of around 370 crores. It's coming at around 443 crores. So even the ready mix business, in fact, has done well, because you're getting volume growth, even though they're a smaller part of their business. Mm. These numbers look good on all parameters. You know, it's beating our estimates. But basically, when your volume grows by 27%, when the rest of the industry is doing what, around 8 to around 10%, yes, they have capacities that are coming on stream, but these numbers look very, very good. And that is the reason why, in fact, the stock has spiked up as we speak.
Okay, Nigel, thanks a lot for that. Well, let's talk a bit about market as well, because it's been an interesting day today. The market is now giving up half of the gains. More than half of the gains have now been given up. Let's bring our experts in then, Ashwini Gujral and Mitesh Thakkar. They'll make sense of things for us, and of course, prepare you for last hour. Good afternoon, Ashwini. It didn't turn out to be a trend day. I mean, it looked like that at around 1 p.m. Your thoughts on whether last hour could have some more moves, and what would be your stock-specific calls?
Well, it gave you some trend. I mean, you could make money on the upside, but picnic seems to be over. And last hour, you know, maybe Bank Nifty can lose 100 odd points from here. A lot of greeniness that you see could be lost, because it's clear that the bears have won this day. From a 450 point Bank Nifty, you are hardly up 200 now. Similarly, on the Nifty, 140 was the high point of the day. Again and again, you know, this 10,620, 640 is pushing the market lower. And that was the fear all day, that, you know, it's a great, spectacular pullback rally, but it'll get sold in two. And given that we have assumed short positions on a multi-day as well as intraday basis, because chances are a lot of people went long in this rally and now are in trouble and maybe need to cut their positions.
Okay.
Having said that, I think metals was showing some out of traction some time back. So I have buys on Tata Steel. That's a buy with a stop of 670, target of 695. Vedanta is a buy with a stop of 310, target of 326. And JSPL is a buy with a stop of 265, target of 282.
Okay, by the way, the street really likes ACC's numbers. The EBITDA number is 100 crores higher than what the street was estimating at 443 crores. So I think all those issues about higher fuel costs, etc., are behind them, at least for now. They do say that they have impacted by an increase in cost of imported coal and pet coke, etc. But despite that, they've managed to see some really good operational figures. Ashwini, hi, afternoon. I wanted your quick thoughts on the cement stocks, ACC in particular, post a good set of numbers.
Cement, you know, even after good numbers, etc., it's not able to light the street on fire. Maybe it means that economy is picking up, etc., etc. But I don't think it's ready to make fresh highs. ACC has hit 1580, 1570 at the low point of the day. So that's a significant previous low when it had bad results. So given that, there's no downside probably, and you know, maybe people can buy, but it'll be a modest rise, you know, couple of $100 higher from here, maybe closer to 1780, 1800 if you must buy ACC. But most of these stocks are way below the 200-day moving averages and hence are a little weak.
Okay, Mitesh Thakkar is also with us. Mitesh, good afternoon. Your thoughts for the last hour and trading calls?
Good afternoon. I think we always believed that this was, you know, V-shaped bounce back and not an start of an upward trend. Though I think I was looking at 10,657 as the selling zone. We just kind of missed that by a few points. Having said that, I think it could be that market might settle down for some time between 10,700. And remember that that was the gap down level on Monday. A weekly gap was created then. So on the upside, 10,700, 730 remains a formidable level for the Nifty to cross. And on the downside, support will come in close to about 10,300. So we might settle down a bit, but I would still believe that the short to medium term outlook has a good chance of making fresh lows. So the idea would be to sell closer to the upper end of the range. I have one buy and one sell call right now. I have a sell on UBL with a stop at 1,094 for targets of 1,025. And Biocon is a buy. Keep a stop at 603 for targets at 640.
Okay, the reason Balrampur Chini, even after weak results, saw that big rally is now out. Just pull out the intraday chart of Balrampur Chini, and the company is going to consider a buyback, a share buyback. This is a stock which, of course, has underperformed, and a share buyback would be a big news for Balrampur Chini, and that's why you've seen this big move right now. 117 now on Balrampur Chini, 117.25. Let's just flash that news again, because this the stock is moving. Ms. Tulsian is also with us. Mr. Tulsian, good afternoon. Thoughts on Balrampur Chini first, considering a buyback?
See, the numbers are seen to be very, very bad. And again, you know, the sugar segment has not performed well. So if you focus on the quarterly numbers, then you are not happy. Now, company is a debt-free company. And in fact, earlier also, they've gone for a buyback. So probably this is again, management may have thought that let's go for second buyback, which is not bad. But I don't think that should be taken as a positive trigger for the stock.
Okay. Well, I'm going to come back to you, Mr. Tulsian. I want to check with you what your views on ACC. But before that, just quickly on the markets. Anuj, you know, this market, although it's doing well for now, just fails to see any kind of conclusive recovery. And is that something that the bulls should be worried about?
Today's been a good day, Sonia, but, you know, of course, at higher level, there's been some, you know, there would be some jitters as well. So at higher levels, you know, you just want to take some profit home as well. But this is not going to be one, you know, slam dunk down market. At lower level, there's buying. And that's you saw even last week as well, even when the market was falling. A lot of stocks were making new highs. Like
quality stocks, yeah.
Exactly, like Ashok Leyland. You know, these kind of stocks did make new highs. So it's... You know, the easy part of the market might have been over from the last quarter. Now you'll have to be really selective as far as making money is concerned. But today, in general, has been a good day.
In fact, since we were talking about quality stocks, Page Industries has just reported their numbers. So let's just ask our team to put out the numbers for you. 621 crores is what the company has reported on the top line. That compares to 528 crores same time last year. So that's almost an 18% jump that Page Industries has seen in their top line numbers. And that's the revenue numbers I'm talking about. And even if you look at the profitability... And the profits have come in at 83 odd crores versus 63 crores. So that looks pretty good. It's higher than the poll as well.
Yeah, it was in the poll is 79 crores. Yeah. So in line with that poll as well. So that's Page Industries for you. Always been the one of the most expensive stocks in the market and right now as well. But net profit of 83 crores versus poll of 79 crores.
But a lot of the quality names are reporting good numbers and the market are not just choosing to reward them, right?
Oh, yes. You know, that's been one good thing about this market, right? Over the last two or three days, good numbers are being rewarded. I think we went through a phase where even the good news was being sold into. Yeah. I think that's behind us. But 19,800 is what we have on Page Industries. Okay, let's move on. Ms. Tulsiyan, thoughts on a couple of other numbers which have been declared today, ACC and Bharat Forge?
Both the numbers are excellent because if you really first take on Bharat Forge, even the management commentary supporting quite a lot, and in fact we have been keeping the positive view because the monthly truck sales numbers of North America market, we have been getting that regularly, and it was expected that Q3 numbers are going to be seen quite good, and in fact I would say that they are better than expectations, and same situation is going to be seen again for Q4 also. And look to the management commentary, looking to the management commentary, that gives more confidence that yes, keep the positive view on the stock intact. Coming on ACC, the cement volume sales of about closer to 7 million ton, 6.92 with a growth of about 27% on a YOY basis, is really extremely positive. And I think that nothing has really, you know, bothered them in allowing them to maintain their margins and all that. And on all fronts, the company has performed very well. So again, very positive view on ACC numbers also, and even the going ahead, keeping positive view on both Bharat Forge and ACC.
Okay, by the way, Page Industries is now surging. And it's a 1,000 rupee rally that we've seen on that stock. Just pull out that the chart. Almost 1,000 rupees, 900 rupees on that one. So
Phenomenal. I mean, in one day. Yeah.
I just remember 1.5 years back, you know, it was, you know, it had dipped below 10,000. Yeah. I remember a lot of people saying that, you know, that's the standard guide. You know, it dips into four digits, you go out and buy. But anyway, that, of course, was a different period now. But...
A lot of smart money bought at 10,000, you know, because you didn't get that. You don't get that opportunity too often in good quality names, right?
Its previous high was what, 23,000, 24,000. You know, I could be wrong, but I don't know. But Mr. Tulsiyan, again, the issue is valuations, right? On Page Industries, what's the call now?
No, the valuations are seen to be quite expensive, and again, this is more a classic case of where the institutional investors and many of the PMS are seen having invested in the stock, and in fact they don't have the courage to book profits and move into the other stocks, because as long as it is very easy for them having bought at a lower rate. But we don't advise this kind of strategy, because if you just see the I agree that the numbers have been good, but it doesn't complement with the valuations at which it has been existing.
Okay, but Kunj Bansal also joins in, the ED and CIO of Centrum Wealth Management. We're getting a lot of numbers, and mostly we've got good numbers that the market is reacting to. Kunj, hi. What are your thoughts first on Bharat Forge? Very good numbers, stock has surged, but if someone's missed out on the rally, is it too late or can one still get in?
Yeah, so Bharat Forge is not something very specifically we own or cover, but the other result that has come, Page Industries, is a stock that we own across our clients' portfolios. Mm. So that something result has come out to be very well, helping the stock cover its underperformance of the recent past. The valuations on that stock has always remained challenging, but those have to be seen in the light of extremely good financials in terms of margins, excessively high return ratios that the stock has. So I think that result has come out well. As I said, Bharat Forge is something not that we are actively looking at.
Okay, by the way, ACC's numbers have really taken the cement sector into a different orbit. Before that, of course, we had Heidelberg's numbers as well. But now if you see, not just ACC, just pull out the intraday chart of a lot of these stocks. ACC, of course, is at the high point, 4.5% higher. Ambuja and Ultratech, just pull out these two stocks as well. They are also trading at high point right now. And of course, you have a couple of others like India Cement from the broader market. That also is moving higher right now. So a lot of these stocks are doing well at this point in time. Kunj, good afternoon. Your thoughts on cement and anything that you like?
So cement as a pack has given quite a mixed performance in this quarter for the numbers declared till now. On one hand are the companies where we have seen volume growth significantly going up in some of those cases led by the capacity expansion. In some other cases, it's purely the organic growth which has happened on the low base of the last year. Margins have in general come under pressure across the sector because of the rising prices. But I think sector is seeing a good participation from investors' interest. Even in this volatility of the last few days, it has remained an outperformer. And we think that as a sector overall, it will continue to outperform.
Well, during the break, Anuj and me were debating whether Virat Kohli is indeed the greatest batsman of all time or not. And we have many Virat Kohlis in the market today, right, Anuj? I mean, look at Bharat Forge, for example, yes. Up almost about 8-odd%. I can compare some of these stocks to Virat Kohli, right? No one's going to get offended, I hope.
I hope so. I think Virat Kohli actually defies a bit of conventional wisdom, right? I mean, in India, you normally hate, arrogance, brash, tattooed, all this kind of... You think that, these people won't be successful. Mm. But he's just, of course, in a different orbit. But I think Bharat Forge, really strong numbers. And it was, 2 years back that the stock was 40% of what it is right now when things were really bad. They were making that acquisition in North America, when things looked really bad. Mm. So obviously, the good time to buy stocks is during the worst periods. And that's what happened with Bharat Forge 2 years
back. Absolutely. In fact, it has a lot of other stocks for company, I'd have to say today. So names like Page Industries, etc. are definitely surging post numbers. And Cipla not too far behind. Let's find out what you should be doing with individual stocks. Sandeep Wagle joins in now. Sandeep, hi. A lot of non-index large caps moving with strength today. What would you buy now?
Afternoon, Sonia. I would go with a buy in a Bharat Forge. I heard you mention that. I am seeing strength. Buy it with a stop loss of 738, target of 774. And a sell in Hexaware, stop loss of 339, target 321.
Okay, time to take some of our queries then. Thanks, Sandeep, for those strategies. Now let's take some queries coming from Twitter. Sunil wants to know the long-term view on HCL Tech and DMart. Mr. Hussain, your thoughts on both these stocks?
See, these type of queries are too general that what is a long-term view unless until the investor has a conviction then, but still I'll try to reply this that if he's having truly the long-term view which I define anywhere about 2 years or so, then he should hold DMart and not HCL Tech because the kind of visibility or the growth prospects seen for the IT companies are not too comfortable. But yes, DMart is a, though again the stock is looking expensive, but we're looking to the growth. The stock DMart is worth holding for long term and not HCL Tech.
Okay, well, next up we have Akash who writes into us. He has 500 shares of GMR Infra at 23.75 rupees. He wants to know whether to hold or to sell. Ashwini, what's the call here? What should one be doing with GMR Infra?
These sort of stocks are good if you buy them at 8 bucks and 10 bucks and 12 bucks. At 23, 24, if you expect, it'll become 50. That often does not happen. So I would, possibly move on maybe to a Yes Bank because, good stocks have also come off. So it would be better to, increase the quality of the stock.
Okay, improve the quality of the stock. By the way, just take a look at the rally in the pharma space right now. It's led by the largest of them all. Of course, Sun Pharma is now at the high point of the day. The last round of move really has belonged to pharma. So Sun Pharma is at high point. That's a Nifty Pharma, of course. Dr. Reddy's, Glenmark, Ajanta Pharma, all these stocks doing well. Wockhardt as well. Just pull out the stock of Wockhardt as well. That stock, of course, came out of F&O ban yesterday and had corrected a lot. So that one has moved to high point of the day. So a lot of these pharma stocks right now doing quite well. Let's take our next query. Kamal has 1,000 shares of Prakash Industries at 251. He wants to know whether to hold or sell. Ashwini, thoughts here?
See, again, you know, probably bought a bit expensive. So, again, the advice is move into a Tata Steel, because if mid-caps are going to go through a bit of a rough patch, possibly Tata Steel will do better than Prakash Industries.
Okay, fine. Tata Steel will do better than Prakash Industries. Yeah, better to always stick with some of the larger cap names. We also have a query that's come in from Sujan. He has shares of Lupin at 923. Okay, so sitting with a loss now. And shares of RBL Bank at 501. He wants to know the long-term view on these stocks. Ms. Tulsian, let's take them one by one. Lupin is sitting on a loss. And we've seen, you know, the way the company has reported weak numbers. You think you should move out?
See, Sonia, he has given a time horizon of 3 years. He is asking that long-term view for next 3 years. So, naturally, Lupin is not going to remain a laggard for next 3 years, because the management commentary says that they are expecting the revival in the fortune maybe from FY19 onwards. They definitely look into the present situation. We have been categorically saying for last 6 months, Lupin has been the worst performer amongst the frontliners, the wealth destroyer. And I've been saying this for last 6 months, that get out of the Lupin. But if he has a time horizon of 3 years, and I don't think that further erosion will happen. Maybe it can fall by about 8 to 10%. But keeping view of 3 years, then he has a prospects of seeing some recovery also. Coming on RBL Bank, an excellent upcoming bank amongst the private sector, and at the current level, though I have other better choices existing in the space, maybe like Kotak Mahindra and Yes Bank, you know, above that, or maybe now Capital First, you know, because that will eventually get merged with the IDFC Bank. So these three are the in the packing order, these three are the better ideas, and then fourth is the RBL Bank. But he can remain invested in RBL Bank also with a view of about 3 years.
Okay, Mr. Sam, we'll thank you on that note. Thanks a lot for your time today. We'll talk to you tomorrow, of course. Kunj, before we thank you, just a word on some of these pharma names which are surging now. Anything that you would want to buy?
Yes, so pharma is one of the contra sectors which is available at very attractive valuation in the current market. Of course, unfortunately, the negative sentiment built on the negative news flow has been affecting the sector more, and as a result, we have been continuously seeing the fall in the shares. But some of the mid-cap stocks like Suven are part of our portfolios, and the results have also come very well. So that's a stock that investors can look at in the mid-cap pharma space.
Okay, Kunj, we'll thank you for your time today. Thanks a lot for joining us. Before I invite Nishil Mahesh, I just wanted to take Ashwani's thoughts on the rally that we're seeing in pharma space. Ashwani, anything that stands out for you?
See, Sun Pharma looks like, finally it's making some sort of higher bottoms. But pharma is, again, stop, start. Maybe IT is the better exporter.
Okay. All right. For now, let's discuss some of the macros of the market. Nishal Maheshwari, the head institutional equities at Edelweiss, joins in now. He joins in from the sidelines of their conference that is underway, the Edelweiss India conference. So let's find out how day one went. Nishal, hi. Good morning. How has it been so far? We know that many corporates, many investors attended your conference, but is the mood still as buoyant as it was about, say, a month ago, or is there now some caution in the system?
Afternoon, Sonia. I think the mood still remains to be optimistic. I don't see much caution at the moment. There has been huge amount of enthusiasm. We have around 160 corporates joining us in the last 2 days and the day tomorrow, and more than 500 clients coming in, funds coming in basically to meet them. So I see huge amount of enthusiasm. Some amount of caution is there basically, as people have seen some soberness, I would say, not caution. Some soberness is there basically, and people are actually trying to figure out what stocks to actually go out and look for in the current fall.